In the name of Jesus, we continue with our study on the book of Galatians.
今天是圣灵，我们来继续查考加拉太书。
In chapter 2, Paul continued to talk about his position in Christ.
在第二章，保罗继续讲明他在基督里的身份。
He explained to the members of Galatians how a person could be justified by faith.
他在这里也告诉当时的信徒，一个人怎么能够因信来称义。
A person's justification does not come through the observance of the law.
所以一个人的称义不是遵守律法而得的。
Paul was in no way denied. He does not deny that the law is good.
保罗没有否认说这个律法是好的。
Rather, he was making a point clear to the church that the law cannot justify those who believe in Jesus.
只是他要讲明一点，就是说这个律法不能让那些相信耶稣的人称义。
So this has been the contention in the time of the apostolic church.
所以使徒时代这是其中一个就是在辩论的一点。
So when you read the Acts of the Apostle 15, we see that some believers from Judea try to teach something contrary to what the apostle taught.
所以在犹太有些人下来就来去传讲一些跟使徒所传讲的相反的。
So we find that kind of teaching not only could split up the church, could actually lead the believers astray from relying on God.
这样的教训不单只会使到教会分裂，也能够使到信徒离开神，不来依靠神。
So the foundation has been laid according to Paul.
根据保罗说，这个根基已经住下来了。
There is no need for us to lay another foundations.
也就是说，我们不需要再来去吝啬另外一个根基。
Our work in this generation is to build on the foundation that has been laid.By the early workers.
所以我们今天的工作就是来去巩固以前早期的这些工人所立下的根基。
Okay, now we come to chapter 3. Yeah?
我们看第三章。
The features in chapter 3 is about the spirit. Yeah?
所以这里所特别提到的就是圣灵的事情。
So Paul actually asked them two similar questions, but very important questions.
保罗问了他们两个大致上同样的问题，但是很重要的问题。
Obviously, Paul was very much saddened by the fact that they had been led astray so quickly and so easily.
当然保罗看到他们这么快就离开这个道理，保罗是非常的难过的。
He also felt that they have been deceived.
也可以说他们这些人已经受了迷惑。
We read verse 2 and verse 5, chapter 3. I think these two questions are also very important to us today.
我们练一下第二节跟第五节这两个问题，对我们来说今天也是很重要的。
Now we read verse 2.
我们看三章的第二节。
This only I want to learn from you. Did you receive the Spirit by the works of the law or by the hearing of faith?
我只要问你们这一件事，你们受了圣灵是因行律法呢，是因信听信福音呢？
Verse 5, yeah.
第五节。
Therefore, he who supplies the Spirit to you and works miracles among you, does he do it by the works of the law or by the hearing of faith?
那是给你们圣灵又在你们中间行异能的，是因你们行律法呢，是因你们听信福音呢？
So the question here, there's two similar questions were posed to the Galatian members.
是同样的一个问题来问。就是来去问这些加拉太的信徒。
How did they receive the Holy Spirit?
他们怎么得到圣灵的？
By the keeping of the law?
是不是守这个律法呢？
Or by the hearing of faith?
或者是因听信福音。
So if we put these two questions, similar questions in our context today,
如果我们把这两个同样的问题放到我们今天来说，
How does a person receive the Holy Spirit?
一个人怎么得圣灵呢？
Today we receive the Holy Spirit.
今天我们得圣灵
because we have heard the truth that preached to us.
因为我们听到这个真理传给了我们。
So meaning that if someone has not heard the truth that preached by the true church here,
也就是说如果一个人没有因听过真教会所传的这个真理，
It's not possible for him to receive the Holy Spirit.
是不可能他能够求得到圣灵的。
I think we have to be very clear on this. Okay?
所以我们在这个问题上应该要非常的清楚。
Because there are so many churches and denominations out there.
因为现在外面有很多不同的教派。
Each claims that they have received the Holy Spirit. They have the abiding presence of the Spirit.
都有人说我们有圣灵的同在，得了圣灵。
Obviously, we don't have to judge them whether they have the Holy Spirit or not.
当然我们不用再去就是说审判他们到底有没有得圣灵。
But in our heart, we know that they don't have the Holy Spirit.
在我们心中，我们是知道他们是没有圣灵的。
Because they have not heard what we preach.
因为他们还没有听到我们所传的。
So I think this idea must be very clear up here.
这样的一种观念，我们应该要非常的清楚。
So do not be confused.
所以我们不要混乱了。
Otherwise, how are we going to preach the gospel of Jesus?
不然的话，我们怎么来传耶稣的福音啊？
And if someone comes to you,
如果有人来到你这里
telling you that he has received the Holy Spirit,
告诉你说他已经得了圣灵
and telling you that his tongue is similar to yours,
告诉你说他讲的灵言跟你的是一样的
do not be deceived.
我们不要受迷惑
了。If this person has not heard about the truth that we preach today,
如果这个人还没有听过我们今天所传讲的真道的话
it is not possible for him to receive the Holy Spirit.
他是不可能来去得到圣灵的。
So the line has been clearly drawn.
所以这条线是已经清楚画出来了。
There's no need for us to go around and survey, you know,all the Christian churches in the world.
所以我不需要到处别的教派来去考察一下。
And to ask them, how do you receive the Holy Spirit, or do you have the Holy Spirit? There's no need to ask.
或者你去问他们，你是怎么得圣灵的呢？其实你是不需要去问。
Because here it clearly tells us.
因为这里很清楚的告诉我们。
The other thing we need to bear in mind is this.
另外一件事情我们要记得的。
If someone do not obey the truth that we preach, the church preaches.
如果一些人他们不遵照教会所传的真理。
It is not, again, it is not possible for them to have received the Holy Spirit.
同样的，他是不可能得圣灵的。
We read the Acts chapter 5.
我们看使徒行传的第五章。
Acts chapter 5.
使徒行传的第五章。
We read verse 32.
五章的三十二节。
Acts 5:32.
五章的三十二节
And we are his witnesses to these things, and so also is the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey him.
我们 为这事做见证，神赐给顺从之人的圣灵也为这事做见证。
We know that the apostles were the witnesses of Christ.
我们知道使徒是基督的见证。
What did they witness about?
他们见证什么呢？
If we turn to the Gospel of Luke,
我们看路加福音书。
We turn to the Gospel of Luke,
路加福音书。
Chapter 24,
路加福音书的二十四章。
Gospel of Luke, chapter 24,
路加福音书的二十四章。
We read verse 46 and to 48.
四十六节到四十八节。
Then he said to them, Thus it is written, and thus it was necessary for the Christ to suffer, and to rise from the dead and dead the third day. 47. And that repentance and remission of sin should be preached in his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. 48. And you are witnesses of these things.
46. 又对他们说，照经上所写的，基督必受害，第三日要从死里复活，并且要奉他的名传悔改赦罪的道，从耶路撒冷直到万邦，你们就是这事的见证。
Now, when you read verse 46 to 48,
当你读四十六节到四十八节
，46 talks about suffering of Christ.
这里讲到基督的受害。
And how he was raised from the dead.
从死里复活。
And verse 47 talk about repentance.
四十七节就讲到悔改。
And the remission of sin.
就是这个赦罪的事情。
We know that repentance here entails the change of a person's old belief to the new one.
这个
是 that they have heard.
这悔改是关也是包括那些以前那些他们的旧的道理，以前的道理。
So
的更正。
So the apostles are witnesses of these things.
所以使徒就是这些事的见证。
So when you read Acts chapter 5.
所以当我们读使徒行传第五章的时候。
We read the one verse 31.
31节
And here it says, Him God had exalted to His right hand to be Prince and Savior, to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sin.
神就用右手将他高举，叫他做君王，做救主，将悔改的心和赦罪的恩典给以色列人。
Meaning that the apostles were talking about Jesus Christ.
就是说门徒在讲耶稣基督。
His suffering.
他的受苦。
Repentance.
悔改。
And the remission of sin.
还有赦罪的事情。
If anyone to whom we preach.
如果我们所传福音给的那个人的对象，
if he does not believe in this,
如果他不相信这一些的话，
it's not possible for him to receive the Holy Spirit.
他是不可能来去得圣灵的。
Not possible at all.
是不可能的。
So if someone who does not believe in the remission of sins through baptism,
比如说一个人他不相信洗礼能够赦罪的话，
and yet he goes around teaching, preaching the word of Jesus,
但是他还是周围来传讲耶稣基督，
performing miracle signs and wonders,
在行神迹奇事，
don't believe in him.
不要相信他。
Very simple ways to discern.
这是很简单的来去分辨。
So we need to understand this.
所以我们要这样的明白。
We know that we have been given the mission to preach.
我们有这个使命要传讲福音。
But we must be able to discern the word of God, from the wrong ones.
我们要从神的话中来去分辨那些传假道的人。
In this way, we will not be deceived by, people outside.
这样的话，我们就不会被外面的人来去受欺骗。
There is no need for us to gather together with them. No need.
其实我们根本不需要跟他们聚集在一起的。
Why? Because there is no truth, no spirit.
因为他们里面是没有真理，没有圣灵的。
Right? Okay, we come back to Galatians.
我们看回加拉太书。
Galatians.
加拉太书。
Now, another point I want to bring to your attention is about, the continuation of the gospel.
我要讲注意另外一点，就是关于这个福音的继续传讲。
We find that actually the mystery of God was hidden in the Old Testament.
神的奥秘在旧约的时候是隐藏的。
In the events of many of his saints.
尤其是在
in the life events of his saints.
在他的圣徒当中的一些他们的生活当中是隐藏的。
For example, in verse 6.
比如说三章的第六节这里说。
Just as Abraham believed God. Verse 8.
第八节。
And the scriptures, foreseeing that God would justify the Gentiles by faith, preached the gospel to Abraham beforehand, saying, In you all the nations shall be blessed.
并且圣经既然预先看明，神要叫外邦人因信称义，就早已传福音给亚伯拉罕说，万国都必因你得福。
So we find that the story of Abraham becomes part of the gospel.
所以你发觉到亚伯拉罕的这个记载就成为这个福音的一部分。
In particular, here what the Lord has spoken to Abraham form part of the gospel as well.
尤其是神对亚伯拉罕所说的话已经成为福音的一部分。
In fact, is one of the very important messages.
已经成为一个很重要的一个讯息。
So God started with Abraham.
所以神从亚伯拉罕开始。
So only those who come to believe in Jesus.
也借着那些来相信耶稣的人，
they shall become the descendant of Abraham.
就成为亚伯拉罕的后裔。
Now, in order to connect Jesus and Abraham together,
要把耶稣跟亚伯拉罕连在一起，
and our belief in Jesus Christ,
我们对耶稣的相信，
so that we can become a descendant of Abraham.
这样的话，使到我们能够成为亚伯拉罕的子孙。
I think we need to refer back to Genesis.
我们应该要看回创世纪。
We turn to Genesis.
我们看创世纪。
We first read chapter 13.
十三章。
Genesis chapter 13.
创世纪的十三章。
We read verse 15.
我们看第十五节。
For all the land which you see I give to you and your, in the actual version it says, your seed. For all the land which you see I give to you and your descendant forever, or I give to you and your seed, singular, your seed forever.
所以说你所看见的一切我都要赐给你。你和你的后裔直到永远。这里说后裔也可以说单数来说一个。
I want you to read chapter 12, chapter 12 verse 7, sorry.
我们看12章的第七节。
Then the Lord appeared to Abram and said, to your descendant I will give this land. And there he built an altar to the Lord who had appeared to him.
12章第7节。神向亚伯拉罕显现说，我要把这地赐给你和你的后裔。亚伯拉罕就在那里 为向他显现的神筑了一座坛。
Now we can turn to also the chapter 22.
22章。
Chapter
22. 22章。
We read verse 18.
22章的第18节。
And here it used the word seed.
18节这里说英文圣经就说一个单数的一个后裔。
In your seed all the nation of the earth shall be blessed because you have obeyed my voice.
并且地上万国必因你的后裔得福，因为你听从了我的话。
Now, sometimes the seed in Genesis refers to descendants of Abraham as in plural.
有时候这个后裔就是指以后的那个世代的亚伯拉罕的后裔。是很多人啊，复数啊。
Sometimes the seed here refers to Jesus.
有时候这里所指的这个后裔呢，就是指一个人，就是耶稣基督。
Okay, now with this understanding, we turn back to Galatians chapter 3.
这样的了解之后，我们可以看回加拉太书的第三章。
Galatians chapter 3, we read verse 16.
加拉太书的第三章，我们看第十六节。
Galatians 3:16.
三章的十六节。
Now to Abraham and his seed were the promises made. He does not say, and to seed, so as of many, but as of one, and to your seed, who is Christ.
所应许的原是向亚伯拉罕和他的子孙说的。神并不是说众子孙，指着许多人，乃是说你那一个子孙，指着一个人，就是基督。
We read verse 19.
19节。
What purpose then does the law serve? It was added because of the transgression till the seed, Jesus, should come to whom the promise was made, and it was appointed through angels by the hand of a mediator.
这样说来，律法是为什么有的呢？原是为过犯偏上的，等候那蒙应许的子孙，就是耶稣来到，并且借天使金中宝之手设立的。
And 19 here, the seed refers to Jesus.
所以这里说的这个子孙是指耶稣。
Now we read verse 29.
我们看29节。
Galatians chapter 3 verse 29.
3章的29节。
And if you are Christ, then you are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. And here the seed refers to those who believe in Jesus.
你们既夫基督就是亚伯拉罕的后裔，就是照着应许所承受的业。这个后裔就是我们相信耶稣基督的人。
So we find that Jesus came from the lineage of Abraham.
所以耶稣是从亚伯拉罕这里来的。
So today if we believe in Jesus Christ,
所以今天如果我们相信耶稣基督的话，
and we are baptized into Christ,
我们受洗归入耶稣基督，
then we come under the spiritual lineage of Abraham.
在灵里我们就是亚伯拉罕的后裔。
So we come under the promise of the Lord.
所以我们也进入耶稣基督的这个应许。
To be a seed of Abraham require us to be baptized and to believe in Jesus Christ.
所以要成为亚伯拉罕的后裔的话，必须要相信耶稣，要接受洗礼。
So this is what Paul is trying to tell us.
这是保罗要在这里告诉我们。
So when you look at the word seed, there is a difference. Yeah, sometimes it refers to Jesus, sometimes it refers to us. Who believe in Jesus.
所以当我们讲到后裔或者子孙的时候，有时候是多数的，有时候只是指耶稣基督一个人而言。
Now, we come to chapter. Do you have any question? Do you want to add on? Okay.
所以受洗归入基督就是一个身体，所以也可以指着就是单数来说，那我们每个人就组成了这个基督的身体，也就是这一个身体。
Okay, I think.We will spend a bit of time to talk about verse 14 when we come to chapter 4. Yeah. Chapter 3, verse 14, we'll spend a bit of time to talk about it.
3章的14节，我们花点时间来去讲解。 当我们讲到第四章的时候
I think the two covenants are very important
这里讲到的两个约是很重要的
They are not just given to distinguish between those who abide by the law and those who abide in faith
不单只是讲到因信或者因立法而说来说的
We can actually use this example to see to understand why God has chosen only one church
所以也从这个用这个例子来讲到为什么神只就是说拣选了一间教会
I think it's quite important if for us to know that there's only one church
我想这也很重要就是让我们明白到只有一间教会
I think if this foundation is not firm
如果我们这个根基不坚固的话
if we cannot believe it with full conviction
我们不能够完全的来相信的话
it becomes difficult to preach
这样传福音就很困难
very difficult
非常的困难
I think we'll tend to compromise
我们可能就会妥协
okay
so I'm going to add to something that I've said earlier about the church and why the church is only one church First John chapter 4
讲到独一的教会我们看约翰一书的第四章第四章的第六节四章的第六节
We are God He who hears He who knows God hears us He who is not of God does not hear us By this we know the spirit of truth and the spirit of God
我们是属神的认识神的就听从我们不属神的就不听从我们从此我们就可以认出真理和真理的灵和妙王的灵就是要正视刚才所讲到的一点
OK Do you have any questions?
OK 有什么问题
OK if not then we quickly come to the two covenants
那我要讲一下这两个约
And then I'll let you ask questions if you have any.
那我就让你问问题，如果你有问题的话。
Now we look at chapter 4.
我们看第四章。
Chapter 4.
第四章。
Here Paul is talking about the two covenants.
这里保罗讲到这两个约。
These two covenants actually stem from the two sons of Abraham.
这两个约是从亚伯拉罕的那两个儿子而来的。
Here it says the one by a bond woman, the other by a free woman.
这一个是为奴妇人所生的，一个是自由的妇人所生的。
But he who was of the bond woman was born according to the flesh.
那些为奴所生出来的是照着肉体而生的。
One is according to the flesh.
一个是照着肉体而生的。
And the other one is according to the promise.
另外
the free woman.
另外一个是照着应许
的 free woman,
是接着这个自由的妇人而生的。
Obviously, the two women here refers to Hagar and what? Sarah.
夏甲跟撒莱。
And here it also Paul uses Mount Sinai.
保罗也用了这个西乃山。
And also what? Jerusalem from above. Yeah?
在上面的耶路撒冷。
Now the son of the born woman is Ishmael.
那个从为奴所生的就是以示玛利。
And then the one from the free woman is Isaac.
所以从那个自由的妇女所生的，应许的妇女所生的就是这个以撒。
Now this is how Paul trying to distinguish between those who rely on the law for justification and those who rely on Christ, yeah?Through faith.
所以保罗想来这里分辨讲明一下因他们有些人想照着立法来称义不同的地方跟那些因信称义不同的地方
This one is Hagar
那个是夏甲
This one is Sarah
那个是撒莱撒拉
Ishmael
以示玛利
And then what is it?
以撒
Isaac
以撒
This one is born woman
这个是为奴的妇女所生的。
And this one is free woman.
这个是自主的妇女所生的。
And then this one is according to the flesh.
一个是照着血气或者是属肉生的。
And this one is according to promise.
另外一个是凭着应许所生的。
And
This one is Mount Sinai.
一个是西乃山。
This one is Jerusalem from above.
这是从上面而来，就是说耶路撒冷， 就是上面而来的耶路撒冷。
Okay, now let's look at this carefully.
我们仔细来看一下。
I think the main point is this, yeah, promise, yeah.
我想那个重点就是这个应许。
And this one is according to the flesh.
另外一个是凭血气。
Now, if you look at the birth of Ishmael and Isaac.
如果我们看以斯玛利的出生跟以撒的出生。
Obviously, they have the same father.
虽然他们是同一个父亲。
Abraham is the father.
亚伯拉罕是这个父亲。
Both the children.
有两个孩子。
But we know that according to the promise of God.
但是照着神的应许。
It's only through Sarah.
只是借着这个撒来
that Isaac would be born.
也就是说以撒 才会被生出来。
God has chosen this this way here, this line here.
神已经拣选了，就是说从那里下来的那个线了。
That's why here is according to promise. This is what God has promised.
所以那里就是指着照着神的应许而做的。
We know that. Here, when you look at this this line here through this woman here, Hagar.
但是我们从夏甲的那个线看下来的话。
Hagar was a born woman.
她是一个为奴的女人。
And then the birth of Ishmael was not according to the promise of what of God, but rather through the flesh.
所以她的出生，以色玛利的出生，不是照着神的应许，而是照着血气而生的。
So when you look at this two covenants here,
所以当你看这两个约的时候,
so from the very beginning of the story of Abraham,
所以从亚伯拉罕的这个记载很早开始,
it has already told us about the coming of Christ.
已经告诉我们基督的到来,
that is the promise.
那是应许,
as early as the time of Abraham, yeah?
甚至已经很早在亚伯拉罕的时候。
That's why we talk about the seed, you remember?
所以当我们讲到这个 子孙这个单数。
So in him, in Jesus.
也就是说在耶稣基督里。
Then what happened? You shall become the seed of Abraham.
你就成为亚伯拉罕的后裔。
This is how Paul distinguished between law and faith.
所以保罗怎么样来去分辨这个律法跟信心因信。
Okay, now if you look at this in the okay, we know that after Sarah died, Abraham has is another wife, isn't
it? 当撒拉死了之后，亚伯拉再娶一个太太。
What's the name?
叫什么名啊？
Keturah. How many children?
Mandy.
How many children she had?
Six.
她有six. Six,
huh? Tira 是中文叫什么？七。她有六个孩子。
Six, okay. Now, this one happened after Sarah died.
这个是撒拉死后。
Okay, look at this in the context of the church.
那我们从教会的这个角度来去看。
Now, we said before the emergence of the true church.
告诉我们在真教会还没有出现之前
there may be many other churches.
可能有很多不同的教会教派。
We can be certain that they are not according to the promise.
但是我们很肯定的，他们不是照着应许的。
You may ask, how do you know?
那你会问，你怎么知道呢？
Can you back it up with the scriptures?
你可以从圣经上来去支持你所讲的吗？
How do you know that all the churches before the true Jesus church are not the church of promise?
那真耶稣教会之前的这些教派都不是应许的教会。
We turn back to Galatians.
我们看回加拉太书的第五章。
Galatians chapter 3.
第三章。
We read verse 14. Yeah?
3章的14节。
Galatians 3 verse 14.
加拉太书的3章14节。
That the blessing of Abraham might come upon the Gentile in Christ Jesus, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith.
这边叫亚伯拉罕的福，因基督耶稣可以临到外邦人，使我们因信得着所应许的圣灵。
Now to receive the blessing of Abraham.
要得到亚伯拉罕的福。
Or to come under this promise, this line of promise.
或者进入这个应许的这个就是在它里面。
Spirit is the key factor.
圣灵就是重点。
So today, if you look at our other churches,
如果我们今天看别的教派
，either before before the True Jesus Church，
甚至真耶稣教会出现之前的教派
，Why are we so certain to say that they are not that this of this line here？
为什么我们这么肯定说他们不是那个应许的那个线上的就属于这应许的里面的呢
？No spirit。
因为没有圣灵。
Now the next question we ask。
另外一个问题我们问。
How do we know that they don't have the Holy Spirit？
那我们怎么知道他们没有圣灵呢
？According to history。
照着根据这个历史的记载。
If you look at their teachings。
如果我们看他们的教训。
They are not in line with what the Bible teaches。
他们所教训的跟圣经的教训是不一致的。
If that's the case, it means that they didn't have the Holy Spirit.
换句话说，也可以告诉我们，他们是没有圣灵的。
No Holy Spirit.
没有圣灵的。
So we are very certain.
所以我们很肯定。
Why? Because today we have the Holy Spirit.
为什么？因为我们今天有圣灵。
Not only that.
不单只是这样。
When we refer to the scriptures.
当我们来去翻圣经的时候。
Whatever we have preached.
我们所传讲的。
Especially with regards to the basic beliefs.
尤其是我们讲我们的基本的教义。
They are all in line with the Bible.
这跟圣经是一致的。
So we have come under the promise.
所以我们进入了这个应许当中。
It's not our own invention.
不是我们的自己创出来的。
It's the promise of God.
是神的应许。
So we are very blessed.
所以我们是很有福气的。
So we must hold on to our faith.
所以我们要持守着我们的信仰。
We know that later on this family here, Haggai and Ishmael were cast out.
之后我们知道夏甲跟他的家人就被赶出去。
Now when you look at Keturah.
当你看另外一个太太所生。
Within chapter
25. 师徒啦。
We can turn to chapter 25. Is that?
二十五章。基徒啦。
Okay, we read the. Before we do that, we read the chapter 24, verse 36.
24章，我们先看24章的36节。
And then we read chapter 25, verse 5.
我们看25章的第五节。
Okay, we first read chapter 24, verse 36.
24章的36节。
And Sarah, my master's wife, bore a son to my master when she was old, and to him he was given all that.He has.
我主人的妻子撒拉年老的时候给我主人生了一个儿子我主人也将一切所有的都给了这个儿子
Verse 5 he says
25章的第五节
And Abraham gave all that he had to Isaac
亚伯拉罕将一切所有的都给了以
撒 But did he give something to this children here?
他有没有给比如说给基图拉的儿子一些东西呢
Yes he did
有，他是有的。
We read verse 6.
我们看第六。
Chapter 25, verse 6.
25章的第六节。
But Abraham gave gift to the son of the concubines which Abraham had, and while he was still living, he sent them eastward away from Isaac his son to the country of the east.
亚伯兰把他的财物分给他，怎么读？孙处的众子，趁着自己还在世的时候，打发他们离开他的儿子以撒往东方去了。
So if you put this into the context of the church.
所以我们今天如果以教会的这个观点来看。
After the true church has come out.
当真教会出来之后。
There are many other churches also continue to spring up.
也就是说也有很多教派也开始起来。
Now we ask a question.
那我们要问一个问题。
Does God give them grace?
神有没有给他们的恩典呢?
Yes.
有。
But what does God give to us?
那神给我们的是什么呢?
Heavenly blessing, everything in heaven.
就是天上的一切的祝福。
We turn to Ephesians.
我们看以弗所书。
Chapter 1.
以弗所书的第一章。
We read verse 3. Yeah?
第一章，以弗所书第一章的第三节。
Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3.
以弗所书第一章的第三节
Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ.
愿颂赞归于我们主耶稣基督的父神，在他基督里曾赐给我们天上各样属灵的福气。
He said, In Christ you receive every blessing.
所以他们这里说，在基督里你领受一切的福气。
Now the question is,
问题是
How can one enter into this in Christ position?
那一个人怎么进入到就是说把自己放在基督耶稣里面呢?
Through baptism, isn't it?
就是接受洗礼。
When you look at baptism itself,
如果我们看就是来去看洗礼本身。
This is not a work of a Baptist.
啊，这不是一个洗礼者的工作。
Actually, it's the work of the Spirit.
啊，其实是圣灵的工作。
That's why the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 13.
所以哥林多前书十二章十三节这里这样告诉我们。
It is the Spirit that baptizes us into Christ.
啊，是圣灵使我们受洗的，成了一个身体。
So only with the presence of the Spirit.
啊，只有圣灵的出现。
Then we can enter into this position.
啊，唯有圣灵的同在，我们才能够进入啊这个啊就是在这个应许里面，基督里面。
That is to be in Christ.
啊，就是在基督里面。
As a result, we receive all the heavenly blessing. We receive everything, just like Abraham was given everything to Isaac.
啊，就好像我们就能够得所有的属灵的福气，就好像啊亚伯拉罕这里说，把所有的都给了以撒。
So if you are asked.
啊，所以人家问你的话。
Do other churches receive grace from God?
啊，别的教会教派没有得到神的恩典吗？
Yes.
有。
But it's not like what we have received.
啊，不是，但是他们所得的跟我们所得的不同。
That's the difference.
啊，这就是不一样的地方。
Yes.
啊。
A blessing, whatever, a gift. Sorry, wrong word.
You can't say it extends to
Or maybe I have not used the word accurately. Change and use another word.
啊，就是说有些教派他们没有完全的真理哦。啊，那他们也不是说也是一种恩典呢。
You see, the key element is the Spirit. Holy Spirit.
啊，这个主要的因素就是圣灵。
If there is Spirit.
啊，当圣灵的出现
，then we come under that line.
啊，我们就进入亚伯拉罕的这条线上。
That's why chapter 3 verse 14 is a very important verse to remember.
啊，所以三章的十四节是很重要的一节，我们要记得。
Because through this promised Holy Spirit, we receive the blessing of Abraham.
啊，借着圣灵的出现，圣灵的应许，我们就有亚伯拉罕的应许了。
Because starting from the very beginning of our conversion,
因为从我们一开起初的这个就是相信。
We can see how we were baptized into Christ.
啊，因为从那里我们看得到我们怎么受洗归入基督。
And that is the work of the Holy Spirit.
啊，就是圣灵的工作。
I think we read that verse. We turn to 1 Corinthians 12.
你看哥林多前书第十二章。
1 Corinthians chapter 12.
哥林多前书的第十二章。
Verse 13.
13节。
The Chinese is not very clear. The Chinese version is not very clear, but the English is very, very clear.
中文的版不是这么清楚，英文比较清楚。
Here it says, but for by one Spirit we were all baptized into one body.
从一个圣灵受洗成了一个身体。
So through the Spirit we were baptized into Christ.
借着这个圣灵受洗归入了一个身体，就是基督的身体。
So when you read Colossians chapter 3,
所以当你看
Galatians chapter 3,
加拉太书的第三章。
So Paul was talking about the work of the Spirit.
保罗在讲到圣灵的工作。
We can read also chapter 4.
我们也可以读第四章。
Chapter 4, we read verse 6.
第四章的第六节。
Verse 6 and verse 7.
六节七节。
And because you are sons, God has sent forth the Spirit of His Son into your heart, crying out, Abba, Father.
你们既为儿子，神就差他的灵，他儿子的灵进入你们的心，呼叫阿巴父。
Verse 7.
第七节。
Therefore, you are no longer a slave, but a son, and if a son, then an heir of God through Christ.
可见从此以后你们不是奴仆，乃是儿子，儿子的既是儿子，就靠着神靠着神为后嗣。
Obviously the heir here refers to the one also mentioned in chapter 3 verse 29.
这个后嗣也就是三章二十九节所提到的后裔。
Here is according to the promise.
这是这里说是照着应许的。
So I think we need to have this firm faith in what God has given to us.
所以我们应该要有这个信心来去接受神所给我们的。
Do not be distracted or do not be affected. Because we have the promise of God because we have the Holy Spirit.
不要受影响，因为我们有神圣灵的应许。
Do not be too concerned over what others talk about our church.
所以别人怎么讲教会我们不要太过去关注。
Because we know that we have received the Holy Spirit.
因为我们知道我们已经得了神的圣灵。
Our mission is to preach.
我们的这个使命就是传福音。
If this foundation is firm,
这个根基如果坚固的话,
then we will not be shaken.
我们就不会被动摇。
Then we can bring people in by the grace of God.
我们就到接着神的恩典，我们就可以把人带进来。
Any question?
有没有什么问题？